So good morning dear cadets. So we are meeting almost after the gap of 3 weeks. So I left this chapter. What is the name of chapter? The name of chapter is separation of substances. Okay, separation of substances. So chapter, here I am writing the name, chapter 5, separation of substances. Separation of substances. Okay, so just try to understand. Almost everything I have completed, 2 things were left. Okay, so I started with the method of separation, definition of method of separation, need of method of separation, then different methods of separation. So I completed hand picking, sieving, winnowing, threshing, sedimentation, decantation, filtration, magnetic separation. Magnetic separation is used for the separation of magnetic material from the mixture, and one magnet must be used. Okay, now evaporation and condensation is left. Almost all methods with the example I have completed. Some small portion from this particular chapter is left, including NCRT exercise. So I will complete the NCRT exercise also, but before the completion of NCRT exercise, whatever portion is left, today itself will complete that one. Okay, so now try to understand. 2 methods were left, evaporation and condensation. So what is the evaporation? Evaporation is the process of conversion of water into vapor from below its temperature. The conversion of water into vapor form below its boiling point. Okay, so just see, water is kept on. Always remember, evaporation and boiling, both are different thing. Boiling takes place at the boiling point of concern liquid, but evaporation takes place at room temperature. That is why I wrote here, conversion of water into vapor form below its melting point at room temperature. At room temperature. Okay, now where evaporation technique is used? Evaporation technique can be used to separate the salt from seawater. To separate the salt can be obtained from seawater by this method. How? Just see, if you had been near the seashore, so what you may have seen, just try to understand. Seawater, because of high tides, seawater is rising up. Okay, so near the seashore, people are digging or making shallow pits. When tide comes, seawater falls on those shallow pits. Okay, now when water recedes, seawater recedes. So under sun rays, what is there? Water gets evaporated. And now what is left there? Since the boiling point means the water temperature, boiling temperature is less. So under the sun rays only water will evaporate, but salt boiling point is very high, so that will not evaporate. Salt will be there only. People will collect that salt and will subject it for the purification and further the addition of potassium iodide. Nowadays salt is sold in the name of iodized salt. So they are adding one substance, that is potassium iodide. That is only iodized salt. Okay, so in this way, with the help of evaporation method, we can obtain the salt from the seawater. Okay, next method is opposite of evaporation is condensation. We'll tell you the use of condensation also, but first remember, it is the process of conversion of water vapor into water. It is the process of conversion of water vapor into water. Means see, during the course of evaporation, water was converted into vapor form. In condensation process, same water vapor can come back into water form. So just see, we can say condensation is the opposite of evaporation. So condensation takes place at higher temperature, but below the boiling point of concerned liquid. Condensation takes place at low temperature only. कंडेंसेशन टेक्स प्लेस एट लो टेम्परेचर. एवापोरेशन रिक्वायर्स टेम्परेचर आर हीट. कंडेंसेशन डज नॉट रिक्वायर. कंडेंसेशन रिक्वायर कूल टेम्परेचर, लेस टेम्परेचर ओनली. सो बोथ आर अपोजिट प्रोसेस. हियर एक्चुअली इन कंडेंसेशन प्रोसेस एनर्जी इज रिलीज. वट एवर अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी इज नीडेड टू कन्वर्ट वन लिक्विड इन टू वेपर फॉर्म, सेम अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी इज रिलीज वेन वेपर ऑफ दैट लिक्विड इज कन्वर्टेड इन टू लिक्विड फॉर्म. ओके, सो दिस इज देयर. सो इन दिस वे ऑलमोस्ट ऑल मेथड्स आई हैव कंप्लीटेड. इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ मेथड. अब नाउ सी द यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ एवापोरेशन एंड कंडेंसेशन. एज फार एज देयर यूटिलाइजेशन इज कंसर्न विद द हेल्प ऑफ एक्स्ट्रा मार्क्स वीडियो आई हैव शोन यू. नाउ आई एम हेल्पलेस टू शो यू द वीडियोज, बट थ्रू माई एक्सप्लेनेशन आई विल ट्राई हार्ड टू एक्सप्लेन द थिंग्स प्रॉपरली. सो नाउ ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड हियर. आई विल गिव यू वन एक्टिविटी हियर एंड विल ट्राई हार्ड टू एक्सप्लेन दैट वन. ओके, सम टाइम सी. सो फार वॉट इज देयर इन ऑल एग्जाम्पल्स वी हैव यूज वन मेथड ओनली. बट देयर आर सम मिक्सचर्स वेयर द कंपोनेंट कैन ओनली बी सेपरेटेड वेन मोर देन वन मेथड इज यूटिलाइज आर यूज. सो सच टाइप ऑफ एग्जाम्पल विल गिव यू. ओके, सो जस्ट सी यूज ऑफ मोर देन वन मेथड. ओके, जस्ट सी वन एक्टिविटी वी विल डू हियर. सेपरेशन ऑफ मिक्सचर ऑफ वाटर सैंड एंड साल्ट. हाउ कैन बी सेपरेट द मिक्सचर ऑफ वाटर सैंड एंड साल्ट. सो जस्ट ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड. साल्ट इज सॉल्युबल इन वाटर. ओके, बट सैंड इज नॉट सॉल्युबल इन द वाटर. करेक्ट और नॉट? जस्ट सी here we are using the properties of those components which are present in that mixture. So salt is dissolved in the water, but sand is not dissolved in the water. So you take mixture in one beaker. Okay, just stir it. After stirring, keep it undisturbed for some period of time. Then what would be there? Since sand is not dissolved in the water, it will settle at the bottom, while above the sediments liquid will be collected. In that liquid, how many things are there? Water is there and salt is there, because salt is soluble in the water. Okay, now you decant it. Just tilt the beaker. So when you tilt the beaker, then the liquid which is collected above the sand, that will come out, while sand will be there only or not. So the liquid, this, what is the name of this process now? We have used sedimentation and decantation. We have used or not? We tilt the beaker. Then when we tilt the beaker, water means liquid part will come out. Okay? So in the liquid, how many components are there now? Two components are there, salt and water. Okay? And now what would be there? Now sand will be in the beaker only. So one component is separated. Now that liquid which you have collected in another pot or utensil, now transfer that liquid to the one kettle. Okay, so when you transfer that liquid to the kettle and keep on the burner, boil it. So when you boil it, then what would be there? Since the boiling point of water is less than that of salt, so the water will evaporate, and from the mouth of kettle the vapor of water will come out. Now you put one broad pan above the vapor. So vapor, they will hit the surface of the pan or any metal utensil you can take, and they will condense. And after condensing, that water can be thrown or can be channelized towards one beaker, where all water will be collected. Now in the kettle, what is left? Salt is left. So now try to understand how many methods we have used for the separation of component of this mixture. We have used decantation, sedimentation. Then what we have used? Evaporation. We have used here condensation. Correct or not? So various method we have used or not? So sometime what is there, if different components are present in the mixture, we can utilize more than one method to separate those components of mixture. सेम एग्जाम्पल इज गिवन इन पेज नंबर 41 ऑफ एनसीईआरटी बुक. यू कैन सी दिस वन. ओके, सो इन दिस वे दिस इज ऑल्सो कंप्लीटली कंप्लीटेड. नाउ वन मोर थिंग इज देयर, कैन वाटर डिजॉल्व एनी अमाउंट ऑफ सब्सटेंस. सो जस्ट सी, फर्स्ट राइट डाउन द हेडिंग, कैन वाटर डिजॉल्व, राइट डाउन हियर, कैन वाटर डिजॉल्व एनी अमाउंट ऑफ सब्सटेंस. सो जस्ट ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड, विल परफॉर्म वन एक्टिविटी एंड विल एक्सप्लेन. जस्ट सी, ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड. हियर टू थिंग्स विल कम, वन कॉन्सेप्ट विल बी रिलेटेड विद द सैचुरेटेड सॉल्यूशन एंड अनदर वन मोर थिंग विल बी देयर. जस्ट सी, विल टेल यू, डोंट वरी. फर्स्ट डू दिस एक्टिविटी. What is that activity? Just see. Try to understand. Take one glass tumbler water. Okay. Now, 1 teaspoonful of sugar you add. Okay. Now, stir it. What you will see? That 1 teaspoonful of sugar is completely dissolved. That completely dissolved or not? Okay. So, now, see. Don't heat that one. Take another 1 teaspoonful of sugar. Again you just dissolve. Okay? Stir it. It will dissolve. So keep on doing so until unless dissolution of sugar in water gets stopped. Okay? One stage will come when the sugar will not dissolve. Rather, sugar will be settled at the bottom. So now you have got the saturated solution. So what is the meaning of saturated solution? Saturated solution is the solution in which no more solute can be dissolved at given temperature. Are you getting my point or not? So, what is saturated solution? Solution in which no more solute can be dissolved. At given temperature. That is known as saturated solution. So, saturated solution is the solution in which no more solute can be dissolved at a given temperature. Now, you have got the saturated solution. Okay. Now, do one thing. The glass tumbler water means that is the saturated solution which you have got. You transfer it in another utensil. Okay. Now keep on the burner and heat that one. Okay. So just see. When you start heating this one, again you add 1 teaspoonful of sugar or pinch of sugar you start adding pinch by pinch. So what you will see? See, now again sugar start dissolving there. Okay, now you keep on heating and keep on adding pinch by pinch, but what is there? Sugar is still keep on dissolving, correct or not? So what we can say here, with the increase of temperature or by heating, the solubility of given compound or given substance in given solvent increases. So please write down that point also. With the heating, the solubility of given substance. increases in given liquid or solvent. Okay, means since you heated that one, that is why again sugar starts dissolving or not? So in this way, what we can say that of course you have got the saturated solution, but if the same saturated solution is further heated, So the given compound or given substance further can be added or further can be dissolved. That is why here I added word given temperature. Given temperature, or you can write at room temperature. So saturated solution is obtained at normal temperature, at room temperature. But if you want to add more amount of solute to the given amount of solvent, then you have to heat it. In this way, your chapter is completely completed. Now, today I am going to give you some question, and tomorrow I will start the NCERT questions. So today I have taught three things. The number one is what is evaporation. What is evaporation? Okay. Next question is what is condensation? What is condensation? What is condensation? Next one is what is saturated solution? What is saturated solution? What is saturated solution? The next one is how can we increase the solubility of substance in given amount of liquid by heating amount of liquid. Okay, just see these questions. Simply by increasing the temperature or by heating we can increase the solubility. Okay, so these questions you write down. Now tomorrow I will complete the means, not fully, but some exercise definitely I will complete. Okay, and after the completion of this chapter we will start next chapter, that is changes around us. Okay, thank you.